Good afternoon and welcome to Audiotree Live. Today is Friday, March 10th, 2017, and we're very excited to have in the studio with us today, Slothrust. Take it away. Y'all can roll on the next song whenever you're ready.
I just want you to love me. I'm not sure you got it in ya.
You're watching Audiotree Live with Slothrust. Thank you three for being here. I really appreciate you guys making the trip. I know you recently had some van trouble, so I'm glad you made it in one piece. What happened to the van you had previously?
Oh, it caught on fire one day when we were driving through central Missouri, just kind of spontaneously burst into flame on the highway.
Oh, my God. Like, yeah. Anyone get injured? Everyone was, like, cool, or?
Only emotionally.
Yeah, only emotionally. Was it, like your favorite van or, like kind of a sentimental connection? You've been touring with it for a while, or?
Yeah, it was our first van. Okay. His name was Abe, and he took us a long way. But he continued on, actually, after the fire
after
for
the
quite
fire?
A while.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
For, like, probably a solid year and a half after that fire.
Okay,
you know, we fixed him up. It was all right.
Cool. And you got a newer one now, right? Is this the new one that you have outside, or is it the same one?
We got a new one, and his name is Gabe.
Abe's brother?
Yeah, exactly.
How do you come? Do you, like, collectively vote on the name, or how does that happen?
I don't know. I think Abraham just felt right for the first one. And then I guess Gabe felt right for the second one. They're kind of related.
Yeah, they're pretty
close. I feel
like
Kyle has a deep connection with the vans each time, and kind of the name just comes to you, right?
Yeah.
Do you, like, work on the vans at all? Do you have any, like, knowledge of auto stuff?
Like, not really. I'll, like, yeah. Super glue some LEDs to something. But, like,
I'm the same way. Like, when it comes to opening the hood, I get, like, totally lost. I have no idea what I'm doing at that point. But, yeah, well, you guys are sounding great, so if you want to roll on that next song whenever you're ready.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Drink seltzer, smoke weed when you can't sleep. Think about shooting birds. Everyone has got a violent streak. I think my face looks like glass, but my body feels plastic. Melt me into a butter. I wish that I was a baby. Behind your tombstone, but the graveyard's not lonely. Plus, who doesn't love a good cemetery? Is not lonely, no need for you to call. come with me.
You're watching Audiotree Live with Slothrust. I would like to go around and ask, like, individually, if you weren't doing music, what would you be doing? Like, career-wise, or maybe even not even a career, just for fun. Like, what else would you be occupying your time with? We can start with Leah, if you want.
Making toys.
Making toys? Like, is there a specific type of toy, or is it just, like, in general, like, any type?
I really like old, bizarre figurines and collectibles that are from, like, you know, 60s, 70s.
That's awesome.
80s, 90s. I also really like stuffed animals that came out of the same eras. Like, I love Popple. I love Glowworm. I love Jibber Jabber.
That's awesome. Is there, like, a specific, do you have, like, a collection yourself? Or is it kind of, like, just you admire them more or less?
Yes, I have many.
Oh, do you? Okay, that's awesome. Is there a favorite one out of all of them?
Oh, I love all of them so much. But
yeah, can't choose.
Popple is always in the bed.
Never leaves, right? What about for tour? Take it for tour? Is it too delicate? You can't do that.
I don't bring her on tour.
Oh, yeah. I don't blame you. And Will, what about you, Will? What do you think you'd be doing?
I'd probably be a cook in a restaurant or something, yeah.
Yeah. Do you cook a lot by yourself, or is it just something you've always wanted to do?
I cook a lot at home. I've always wanted to work in a restaurant, but my hands are too valuable to me to risk getting cut off.
Yeah, you got to play the music instead, yeah. Right? Well, on tour, do you bring anything? Because, like, sometimes when I'm on the road, I'll bring, like, a propane stove and cook on there. Do you do anything like that, or is it mostly just getting by?
It's mostly, you know, if we ever have the luxury of staying in an Airbnb or something, mm-hmm. we'll go get grocery shopping and cook dinner. But
yeah,
we've thought about once bringing a crock pot on tour, but honestly, there's no room in our van for anything like that.
Pretty
one day, maybe.
Yeah, maybe when you upgrade to a Gabe's brother. What about you, man? What would you be doing?
I think I would, like, design board games or something like that.
Yeah, no, that's cool.
Into, like, game design. Yeah.
Well, yeah, maybe you and Leah could do, like, a thing. Yeah, totally. Start a little company here. Yeah. And then Will can cook for you when you guys are designing, right? It's rad. Cool.
That sounds great.
Yeah.
Well, no problem with that situation.
Will cooks for us all the time. It's amazing.
That's awesome. That's cool. Well, I see now that, like, this is kind of, I guess you would say, your career at this point, because I see you guys are on tour a lot. And also, you just moved to L.A., correct? How did that work out, and how did that go, I guess?
Worked out great.
Yeah.
We all have a lot more space out there. The vibe is nice. The mm-hmm. space thing, I think, is really big for us because we all have a lot of instruments and want to feel like, you know, a sort of openness in our surrounding.
Mm. Kind of like a home where you guys can all kind of get together. Because before, were you somewhat separate?
Well, we were all living in Brooklyn for quite a while, and then Will moved to Philly, and then Kyle moved to Philly. And we just, you know, kept making it work, but
that's awesome.
It's nice to all be in the same area again.
That's cool. And I know I have a friend, Christina. She just moved from LA back to Brooklyn area, and she played shows along the way, like, to get there. Did you guys just all fly out, or was it kind of like a tour to home destination place, or how did you go about doing that?
No, we all got there totally separately. I went
did
there
you?
First.
Okay.
I drove with my girlfriend from the East Coast.
Cool.
And then Will and Kyle made their ways independently. Will, you drove as well, right?
Yep. But this is kind of like that. This tour is a little bit, all of our gear was still living on the East Coast. So now we kind of flew back to the East Coast, got the van, got all the gear, and now we're touring back to the West Coast.
Cool. Well, I'm glad you guys could swing by on your way. If you want to roll to the next one, you can head on in.
Dreaming of
like inner tubes in your grandma's
I'm curious, before you roll in these last two, I really want to know about your lyrics and where you gather inspiration. Do you have to get in a certain headspace? I really enjoy them, and I think they're super unique. And I wanted to know, like, do you get in a certain headspace, or do you find inspiration somehow, or how do you come up with those, like, kind of creative lines you do?
A lot of it kind of just comes to me in no particular order, in no particular way. Mm-hmm. I think that a lot of this record, the lyrics were inspired by sort of dreams and a little bit like more out of body, harder to pin down cerebral stuff. Mm-hmm. But generally speaking, I try to notice details about the world and think about a context to put them in that make them mean more than they might initially.
Cool. That's awesome. Do you find that kind of same, you know, like you were saying, out of body or dream-like things to inspire your art as well? Because you do art too, right? On top of this, like another form of art.
Mm-hmm.
And what is that? And how do you kind of approach that type of art?
I find that for me, the most effective way for me to create art and like art books and that sort of stuff, mm-hmm. is by just being entirely non-judgmental of yourself while you're doing it and putting as much out there, mm-hmm. with no filter and not having expectations of, yeah. what comes out. I think when I was a kid, when I would make a lot of art, I had really fixed ideas of what the end product should be. And I think it's actually more effective if you don't get hung up on that and just sort of see where it takes you and, mm-hmm. try not to judge yourself throughout the process.
No, I think that's great. Like, kind of just let it flow out instead of, you know, constantly trying to manipulate or change it. Just kind of let it happen. And that's, unless you need it, unless it's needed for that, for sure. But yeah. I was curious too, like with the art on your album, did you do that as well? Or how did that come out? Because I really, really like the artwork.
Oh, thank you. Right. The cover and back cover of it is taffy that we encountered on the road. If you go to a lot of rest stops, that some of them have these like really elaborate candy displays.
Really? Okay.
And they're amazing, and I just love how they look aesthetically. And I was sort of obsessively photographing all the candy in these like perfect squares, and I liked the blue taffy the most because it looks like the ocean a little bit, and it's saltwater taffy, so I feel a connection there. And the inside of the record has these photos of the ocean that I took throughout, you know, our journey is my journey, whatever.
Yeah.
So yeah.
That's totally cool. Well, I really enjoy it, and I enjoyed you guys being here. So thank you so much. You can roll into that last little set whenever you're ready.
Thank you.
Thank you.
bit my tongue last night. Woke up with blood on my pillow. I woke up thirsty. Words make less sense to me these days. Faces look flat and unfamiliar. Do you want to rise forever? Underwater, it gets better. When I get better, I'll treat you like I used to. I'll do the things. Everything is so unfamiliar now.
Audiotree Live with Slothrust. Thank you again for coming in. You sounded amazing.
Thanks for having us.
Anytime, anytime. You can also catch them on tour. They're on tour right now, so make sure they're coming to a city near you, so make sure you pop in and check that out. Their new album, Everyone Else, is out now, so you can pick that up wherever you get your records. Also want to thank the lighting and camera crew, everyone here at Audiotree who kind of helps make this happen. We really appreciate that. You can help support the band and us by downloading the session when it comes out in a few weeks. Until then, we'll see everyone next time.
Thank you very much, everybody.